Hello guys and welcome to the Best Squad. My name is Bress and I make weekly gaming videos, so please consider subscribing if you're new to the channel or if you haven't already subbed. One of the things that makes Cyberpunk stand out and part of the reason it was hyped up the way it was is the character customization. This feature looked promising and body modification is one of the major themes CDPR brought out in this game. There is very little limit to what cybernetic implants you can get and you can even opt out if you want. That's what I like about the game. It doesn't force you to follow a set path. If you want a fully organic body, that's also an option. So in this video, I'll go over the best and most important cybernetic implants in Cyberpunk and body modifications that you should own. And I'll also show you the locations where you can get them. I'll go through every part of the body, so if you're only interested in a specific body part, feel free to scroll over to that part in the video because I have chapters for each of the body parts, but I recommend that you watch the whole thing so that your character can be fully optimized. Keep in mind that even though you can choose to opt not to have cybernetic implants, it is very important that you put some implants, especially interior implants, since they don't affect your appearance but they boost your stats, and if you're playing on the harder difficulty levels, it's a no-brainer that you need to have implants to survive. Sorry for the very long intro, but now that that's done, the first body part is the arms. In my opinion, the best arm implant to have are the gorilla arms. They are metallic arms and fingers and they charge with each attack, and when you charge your attack for a strong hit, you get bonus damage. Gorilla arms only deal physical damage and will not kill the enemy, they'll only incapacitate them, and this is really helpful when you're dealing with cyberpsychos and you want to capture them alive. You see, your fixers give you a larger reward when you incapacitate the cyberpsychos than when you kill them, and in that case, they can really come in handy. With gorilla arms, you can open locked doors and rip turrets from their bases, which is a really cool thing. The other arm implant that would be amazing to have are the mantis blades. These blades slice and dice your enemies, and they're faster, much faster than the gorilla arms. They have fast attacks and combos connect quicker, but the reason I prefer gorilla arms to the mantis blades is that mantis blades are lethal, they'll kill, they won't incapacitate, and if you're going for the kill, it's better to use your gun or your other abilities. Mantis blades are more cool looking and beginner friendly because you won't need to master the art of dashing and dodging, but you'll not be able to capture some enemies alive even if you want to. Arms require a high body stat, so you should focus on spending your points on the body stat to fit more sophisticated arm implants. Also, arms only have one empty spot available for implant installation, so you can only have one implant installed at a time, though you can also purchase multiple implants and swap them, but you can only swap them at a Repodoc, so keep that in mind. The gorilla arms and mantis blades can be found at Dr. Chrome, who's located in Watson near a certain marketplace. He's the doc who's really buff and huge. After the arms, we have the integumentary system. This is the shoulder area and it has 3 empty slots for installation of the implants. The implants in this area are internal, so you can't physically see them. The first one I recommend is the subdermal armor, and this is a legendary tier implant that increases your armor by 200, and a high armor implant means that you can afford to compromise on your cloth stats, because once you have a high armor stat, you can go for stylish clothes instead of heavily armored ones. The second one is the heat converter. The heat converter makes you resistant to fire damage, so when you're affected by burn, instead of receiving damage from it, you deal 10% more damage. It literally makes you better when you're burning in fire. The only thing with this is that it requires a level 14 cool stat to be able to equip it, so invest in the cool attribute if you're interested in this. It's nice if your playstyle is running and gunning, but it's not that much useful if you prefer stealth. Third, we have the supradermal wave. The supradermal wave grants you immunity to bleeding, so bullets and blades won't deal extra damage once they've already hit you once. These implants can be found at Dr. Chrome, and I'll put a link with the locations of all the Reaper docks in Night City and all the implants they offer, so be sure to check out for that. The next body part is the legs. The legs only have one slot available, and in this slot, you can either have the fortified ankles, which give you a power jump if you hold the jump button, or you can have the reinforced tendons, which grant you the ability to double jump. I recommend that you get the fortified ankles because the power jump has so much more potential than the double jump. It allows you to reach places that could otherwise be unreachable and gives you the ability to take alternate routes when you're invading an enemy base and you want to maintain stealth. You see, most fences are too high to double jump over, but with the power jump, you can hold the jump while you sprint, and this will add more forward movement to your jump. Another cool thing that many people don't know is that you can take amazing photos in amazing poses mid-air if you have the power jump. And yeah, both of them can be found at Dr. Chrome's. Next, we have the skeleton. The skeleton implants are internal and it has two empty slots, and the Reaper dock in Badlands is the best for skeleton implants. He's located at Sol's camp with the Aldecados, and the first awesome implant he has available are the titanium bones. He has the uncommon variant of the titanium bones, which increase your carrying capacity by 40%. Other Reaper docks also have titanium bones available, but they usually only have the common variant, which only increases your carrying capacity by 20%. The second implant that he has is the uncommon variant of the synaptic signal optimizer, which increases your health by 30%. It also says that it enhances the body's natural resistance and performance. And both these implants are fairly cheap, and the titanium bones cost 1500 eddies, while the synaptic signal optimizer costs 6000 eddies, which is relatively cheap if you look at other implants. Moving on to the circulatory system, this is also an internal implant and it has three slots available. The Reaper dock in the Badlands is also the one I chose in this sector. And the first great implant available at this Reaper dock is the Adrenaline Booster, which instantly restores 40% of your stamina when you defeat an enemy, but it requires a level 13 body. The second implant is the Bioconductor, which is of rare tier, and this reduces all cyberwork cooldowns by 10%. It requires a body stat of level 12, so keep that in mind. The third amazing implant he has is the Biomonitor, which is of legendary tier, and it gives you an instant 100% health when your health drops to 15%, and it also has a 2-minute cooldown. And the downside is that it requires a high body level of 18. If your body level is too low, you can also opt for the Blood Pump, which is a budget version of the Biomonitor, and what this does is that it instantly restores 70% of maximum health, but with this, it's not automatic, you have to manually trigger it, and it has a 3-minute cooldown. For the nervous system, there are two empty slots, but I only found one crucial one that you must have, and this is called the Kerezikov. I hope I spelled that right, and it allows you to aim and shoot while dodging. Time is also slowed down for 60% for 1.8 seconds while you're blocking, aiming, or attacking during a slide or dodge, and this effect has a 5-second cooldown. I found this mod at Dr. Crowman. You should have it too, it's really game changing. Moving on, the next body part is the operating system, and there's only one slot available in this case. The Reaper dock at the Badlands comes in clutch again in this case, and he has an implant called Biodyne MK.2. Which is an improvement to the OS you get from the first Reaper dock, and it has a base RAM of 9, and more RAMs means more consistent and faster hacking, which is useful if you're trying to be stealthy. The buffer size is 6, and a large buffer size means that performing quick hacks on target will be much easier, and jacking into machines and cracking sequences will also be much easier since you'll have more slots to work with, so that means a larger probability to solve the sequences and 4 slots for quick hacks. We're almost coming to the end of the video, and thanks if you're still watching, thanks for hanging in there. And the second last body part is the frontal cortex. It's internal and has 3 slots, and the Reaper dock in the Badlands has a really nice implant called Mechatronic Core, which increases damage to drones, mechs, and robots by 20%. This is nice because those things can be really annoying to fight against, especially since they don't bleed or flinch like other human beings. And to finish off, we have the ocular system. These are the eyes, and there's only one spot available for the eyes. The Badlands Reaper dock has an implant called the Kiroshi Optics MK.2, which is an improvement to the optics that you originally own, and they enhance vision to the same extent as the one you own. But the nice thing is that they have two empty cyberware mod slots, and you can use this to add extra packs onto your optics. And yeah, that was all for today's video. Hope you found some value in it, and if you did enjoy the video, please leave it a thumbs up, and if you want more cyberpunk content, subscribe and hit the notification bell so that you stay updated with my channel. And I'm really enjoying this game at the moment, and I have so many videos planned ahead, you only want to miss them. So subscribe and get notified and stay updated. See you in the next one. Have a lovely day. Ciao.